and Dr. Jovi, Director General of IAS, and IAS members for their kind invitation to this interesting conference. As a matter of fact, I have arrived 2 o'clock in the morning, so I try to overcome the jet lag. Anyway, it is indeed my pleasure and privilege to have an opportunity to speak on higher education in Korea and also to share our experiences with you. What I'm going to present for you for the next 25 minutes as follows. As an introduction, I will talk about brief background of Korean situation. Then I will talk about current status of higher education in our country and challenging issues we are facing now, and the university reformation plan that is under implementation by the Korean government to enhance university competitiveness. Then I will present our institute, KAIST, a leading research-oriented university in Korea, which has a mission to educate science-talented students. Finally, if I have time, I will discuss the desirable role of the university in the knowledge-based society of 21st century. About half a century ago, Korea was one of the poorest countries in the world. At that time, a Time magazine reporter in USA wrote, "To hope Korea become prosperous is like to expect a rose blossomed from garbage can." But his prediction is now turned out to be completely wrong. There is no other nation that achieved industrialization, democratization, informatization, and globalization all in a short period of 60 years. So it is frequently referred as a miracle of Han River. Han River is located in Seoul, separate north and south. And during this period, Korea has grown from one of the world's poorest nation into a developed country. In particular, economic growth in this period is remarkable. For instance, the national GDP increased by 520% during this period. Quantitatively, Korea now joins the ranks of world's top 10 countries. However, qualitative aspects, such as per capita GDP and product per hour, quality of life are quite behind. In particular, Korea's per capita income has stopped its growth around $10,000 level since the national financial crisis occurred at the end of 1997. Then what is the future of Korea? There are two scenarios. One scenario is to follow the N-curve economic growth, which will lead Korea into becoming the advanced nation. The other scenario is to follow the M-curve, pulling the nation back to being an underdeveloped nation. In the 70s, In the 70s, labor and capital's contribution to Korea economic growth was 55%. The contribution rate of technology innovation reached only 13%. However, in the late 90s, the contribution rate of labor capital dwindled down to 37% as the contribution rate of technology innovation increased to 55%, showing how the technology contribution has gained more importance. This also shows that Korea is getting even closer to becoming a knowledge-based economy. In knowledge-based economy, knowledge creative human resources is a key growth engine. So it is not exaggerating to say that our nation's future depends on whether or not Korea is able to produce such human resources. For this reason, the importance of education is currently being seriously pondered upon in our country. Speaking about Korea's higher education, Korea has achieved remarkable quantitative growth, just as economic growth. Here are some numbers representing the growth of higher education in Korea. Number of higher education institutes has grown by 270% in the last 30 years. And now there are more than 380 universities and colleges. The number of enrolled students grew by 18 folds over the last 30 years. So there are now 3.6 million students enrolled in universities. The ratio of students pursuing higher education is 82%, the world's second highest next to Finland. And the ratio of undergraduate and graduate students over population ranked top in the world. Encouraged by this quantitative growth, the higher education has become accessible to general public. 41% of Koreans have received some form of higher education, placing Korea first in the world. However, such quantitative-oriented growth has brought about many challenging issues in university education. First challenging issue is that Korean universities generally do not provide qualified human resources required in the knowledge-based society. Consequently, there are mismatch between the supply and demand of human resources. Korean companies are not satisfied with the quality of human resources produced by Korean universities. So they have retrained fresh employees with annual expenses of $2.8 billion. Second issue is a surplus of entrance quota. Policy to expand opportunities for higher education caused the number of university student quota to exceed that of high school graduates. Last year, for instance, the entrance quota exceeds the number of high school graduates by 14%. The third challenging issue is the financial support for the public education for students is very low compared to advanced country. Education expenses is comparatively high with respect to GDP ratio. That is 4.8%, comparable to average of the OECD country. But the actual amount falls short to that of the advanced country. Because of unsatisfactory public education, parents must undertake huge expenditure in private education, which amounts to $13.6 billion, just looking at the case of year 2003. Due to the mistrust of public education and failing to adopt a university entrance system, number of young students who go overseas increase. Korean parents are willing to sacrifice their family life to provide their children with a better education in the advanced country. As illustrated in these funny cartoons, father working in Korea is separate from his family living in foreign country and visit his family once a year, like a migratory bird. So such is jokingly dubbed wild goose father. The last, but not least, challenging issue is a trend in which the young generation of the science and engineering field, as previous speaker mentioned, and other countries too. This is not a problem unique to our country, but post-industrial syndrome that has already happened in advanced country 10 or 20 years ago. In Korea, unfortunately, such syndrome emerged after national crisis occurred at the end of 1997. The percentage of students applying for science and engineering field, as shown in this pink color, suddenly dropped from 42% in 1998 to 27% in 2002. As already mentioned in the beginning of my talk, knowledge making human resources is a key engine for the growth of Korea. In this regard, many challenging educational situation, which I have pointed out, is a serious obstacle for the future of our country. So our government realized the seriousness of current educational situation and therefore initiate reformation of Korean universities from last year with a catchphrase that higher education competitiveness is nation competitiveness. The national reformation is planned with the three basic principles. Those are from quantitative expansion to to qualitative upgrade from department store style policy to specialized shop style policy with a differentiation and specialization, and reinforcing the university industry ties. Let me explain what are the major action plan undergoing now for the reformation of universities. For a qualitative upgrade, government enforced the universities to downsize the student body and also to merge among universities. The entrance quota will be reduced up to 15% by the year 2009. 10 national universities are under merging now, and 50 national universities will be merged in the 35 by 2007. Eventually, number of universities will be reduced to 25% by the year 2009. For differentiation and specialization of universities, universities are categorized as a research-oriented university, education-oriented university, and vocational colleges. Research-oriented universities are specialized to nurture advanced core professional researchers in basic, applied, and interdisciplinary fields. These universities are supported by so-called Brain Korea Project, which amounts to $2.3 billion during coming 7 years, starting this year. Education-oriented universities are specialized to nurture middle-level engineers to lead regional innovation. These will be supported by so-called New University for Regional Innovation, we call NURI Project, which amounts $1.3 billion during next 5 years. Two-year colleges are specialized to educate on-site technicians. To improve the university industry ties, to improve the university industry ties, demand-oriented human resource training, which satisfies industry requests, is strongly recommended. To achieve this, customized education, especially in science and engineering universities, are enforced. For example, semiconductor specialists are nurtured at 5 universities by request of Samsung Electronics. And automobile management specialists are trained in our university by request of automobile company. Promoting technology transfer and commercialization at universities are another key issue. For this, special venture law was made to allow professors and even students to start a business. Industry University Cooperation Office is independently operated at the university to enable transfer of technologies, IPs, manufacturing and sales of goods. Also, technology holding company system will be implemented to invest in spin-off companies from the university. E-learning will be promoted by utilizing excellent IT infrastructure in our country. For this, cyber home teaching service and ubiquitous learning schools are planned. Well, now let me shift gear a little bit to present about KAIST, a leading university in Korea in charge of a higher education for science-talented students. KAIST was established in 1971 by a special foundation law. It is the first research-oriented, graduate school-oriented university in Korea. The motivation was to stop the brain drain and to educate allied scientists, engineers in the country who were urged needed for the industrialization of Korea. To recruit the top-notch students, government provided with special benefits to KAIST students, such as full tuition, full scholarship, and waiving military obligation. That was big. You know, we are still under tension between North Korea and South Korea. But it's a big, you know, advantage, benefit to KAIST students. I should mention, here are many developing countries, so I'd like to mention two persons who played crucial roles for the foundation of KAIST. One is Dr. Geun-mo Jung, who is the current president of Korea Academy of Science and Technology. He proposed an idea to form a completely new educational institute with a clear vision to educate science-gifted students in the country at the age of 32. It's much, much younger than my age at the time. But so the other gentleman is late President Jeong-hee Park, who strongly support this ideal against the immense opposing opinions from existing university. You may imagine that because, for instance, professor salary is 3 times higher than other university professor. So there are immense opposing opinions. So without these two gentlemen, KAIST could not be born in Korean society. So I'd like to mention that vision and support are very important to initiate a new educational system. KAIST has a unique student selection and educational system. We adopt all the admission of high school juniors, and also we have a continuous education for science-gifted students from 18 science high schools, which are located around the country. And we select through recommendation and in-depth interview. It was our first case in Korea. And also, we have a special training program for gifted students, such as RNE program. For instance, RNE program is the science kids participate in the KAIST professor lab. So they have an experience to expose a cutting-edge research area. Here are some statistics of KAIST current, status. KAIST has produced nearly 30,000 allied scientists and engineers last 30 years. Recently, about 400 PhDs are produced every year. KAIST graduates account for 20% of domestic science engineering doctor, and 25% of doctoral level human resources, major industries, including Samsung, LG, Hyundai, are KAIST graduates, and 11% of professors are KAIST graduates. So many people mentioned the rating. So we are really concerned the rating. So according to the Times evaluation and in these years, in science area, we are ranked 82nd, and in engineering area is ranked 37th. The vision of KAIST in the knowledge-based society of 21st century to become the world leading research university, especially in education, KAIST plans to nurture knowledge creative global leaders who played leading roles worldwide. To achieve this, we implement 3 educational principles, such as cross-disciplinary education, entrepreneurship education, and leadership education. For cross-disciplinary education, we have installed a college of cross-disciplinary studies, first time in our country, and several interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary programs are going on under this college, such as Department of Biosystems, Graduate School of Cultural Technology, and Graduate Program of Medical Science Engineering, Nanotech Program, Robotech Program. I'd like to specifically mention about 2 programs under this college. One is Biosystem Department. This department was initiated with a donation of $30 million from a Korean businessman, with a mission of creating a new knowledge and technology in the huge field of biology, information technology, and nanotechnology. Many multidisciplinary areas, including bioinformatics software, brain-computer interface, nanodrug delivery, are under study. The other program I'd like to mention is the Graduate School of Cultural Technology, which we have started from the last year. The background of the foundation is the cultural industry has emerged as one of the core post-industrial sector, which occupies 8% of GDP in Korea. The objective of this school is to provide high quality expertise to the cultural industry and to pursue a new educational model for cultural rich society, which creates the values by merging engineering, art and culture, and management. The school is fully supported by Ministry of Culture and Tourism. For entrepreneurship education, KAIST launched a graduate school of management with a particular emphasis on technology, information, environment, and knowledge in a global society. In particular, we start business economics minor program from last year to enable KAIST undergraduate students to add basic business skill to their powerful science and engineering knowledge. It is truly important to watch.
4 minutes.
Yes, okay.